Welcome back, Southside, and happy Easter to everybody. I hope everyone's doing great. Let's just go ahead and review last week. Last week we looked at an attribute which was omnipresent. And omnipresent meant that God was everywhere. Today we're going to look at our second attribute, which is omnipotent. Omnipotent, if we break it up into those two parts like we did last week, we have omni, which means all, and potent, which means power or powerful. So when you put it together, you're going to have our attribute, which is God is powerful. When we think of power, each of us might think of a couple different things. Some might think power in machines. Some power in water. Some power in weather. Some power in dynamite or explosions. Or no matter which one we think of, it has to do with power. When we talk about God's omnipotence or God's power, we can talk about the strength and his sovereignty or his supreme control over everything. Doing research, I was able to look up the word power, and power in scriptures is used well over 200 times. The majority of those times is talking about God being powerful. I also looked up the word almighty. Almighty is used over 50 times. And again, that's talking about God's power. In the Bible, there are many, 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 many stories or accounts that talks about and shows God's power. We can start at the first verse of the Bible in Genesis 1:1, where it says, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." This is talking about God has power over creation. God has power over everything. We can continue on and see where he flooded the earth because of sin. We move into the book of Exodus and we see in the 10 plagues, when God is using the plagues, his power over creation to free the Israelites from the Egyptians. With this being Easter Sunday, God has shown his power over sin and death. God is so powerful that death could not hold him. In Peter's sermon in Acts 2:22 through 24 says, "Men of Israel, listen to these words." And these are the words of his prophet Joel. "This Jesus, the Nazarene, was a man pointed out to you by God with miracles, wonders, and signs that God did among you through him. Just as you yourself know, though he was delivered up according to God's determined plan and foreknowledge, you used lawless people or sinners to nail him to the cross and kill him. God raised him up, ending the pains of death, because it was not possible for him to be held by it." Wow, did you catch that? God is so powerful that even death could not hold him. Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and he raised from the dead because death could not hold him back. Our God is so powerful that death could not hold him. And here we are on Easter celebrating his resurrection because, again, death could not hold him. Wow, what a thought. Christ's power paid the penalty for our sin. In Romans 3:23, it says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." In this verse, we are all sinners. And because of our sin, we fall short of God's glory. Then, in Romans 6:23, it says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." Jesus dying for our sins on the cross and rising from the dead, he has shown his omnipotence. He has shown his power and sovereignty over sin and death. and through that he paid our penalty for our sin. It's a gift. God dying for our sin is a gift, and it can be received. In Romans 10:9, it says, if we confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Wow, what great power we see in Christ. We can have the power in us with having Christ living inside of us by heaven. In Matthew 17:20-21 says, because of your little faith, he's talking to his disciples about their lack of faith, and he said, he told them, for I assure you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will tell this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. However, this kind does not come out except by prayer and fasting. Wow, we just looked at it, how powerful God is. He's got power over creation. He's got power over sin. He's got power over death. He's got power over every living thing. What great power. And we can have it by having faith in Christ. If we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we can say to that mountain, move, and it will be moved. Nothing will be impossible for us with faith. God being in our life, he can give us the power that we need. Are you ready to go out with God's power? Are you ready to go out in faith? As we finish up with this attribute, talk as a family about other passages in scriptures that tell of God's omnipotence. I was only able to mention a few, but there are so many more. In fact, every chapter can talk about and shows God's power. Every verse shows God's power. Also, talk with your family and think, how does this attribute of God's omnipotence affect your life and how we should live? What an amazing thought that on this Easter Sunday, Christ rose from the dead because death couldn't hold him back. He rose to give us life. He rose from the dead. He died on the cross to take away our sins. Death couldn't hold him. I hope you guys have a great Easter, and I hope you guys have a great week. See you, Southside.